picked up by Rudolf Charlie. Penalty, the South Africans going around in an offside position. There's the new cap in the background, Philip Skutter. The breeze blowing at the back of the Scottish backs, so they're playing with the wind. Craig Chalmers with a touch kick. Well, played for the British Lions, had a bit of an injury last year and didn't play that often, but you can see a lot of experience. 36th, 37th test match today. Talking about 37 tests, 38 tests, the record for Jan Ellis and Frik de Pryor, and Frik de Pryor is with the South African touring party. So Kenny Mullen with the first throw into the line-out. It's robbed by the South Africans. That's a good kick up by Joost van der Westhuis, and Henny LaRue is there very quickly. So was Chester Williams.
Yes, the first scrum from the wedstrijd. Meneer Doyle, the scheidsrechter from Ireland, said the break in 1984 gemaakt. In Cardiff, to a toetswedstrijd hanteren tussen Wales in Scotland. Ons kan vir die mense by die huis sê dat die Springbokke baie gemotiveerd is om hierdie toets te wen. Ons het saamte hier by die veld aangekom. Die spanning was duidelik sigbaar op die gesigte. In die eerste 20 minute vandag hier gaan van kardinale belang wees.
Well, that's Tommy Loubser against Alan Sharp. Tommy Loubser playing in his third test match today. Alan Sharp just his sixth test match. You can see there that the South Africans is a little bit heavier than their Scottish counterparts. Oh, and this is a penalty in a very kickable position. The referee saying that the Scottish front row collapsed the scrum. It was Paul Burnell who was blown up. Doddy Wears, the number 8, has played lock before for Scotland. He's a tall guy, about 1 meter, well, just about 2 meters tall. Now, this is the moment that all South Africans are waiting for. Can Andre Joubert sustain the incredible form that he's shown on this tour?
Andre Joubert, wat vandag in sy 10de toets vir die Springbokke speel, hy spog met 42 toetspunte. Hy het ook in 1991 vir die Britse Barbarians op die eindste Murrayfield gespeel. Andre Joubert, nou ja, hy het nou donderdag sy skoppe hier op Murrayfield geoefen. Dit het nie baie goed gegaan nie, maar nou is dit die groot geleentheid. En Andre Joubert, wat die Springbokspan met 3 punte 10-0 kan laat voor.
His kicking, the going underfoot is reasonably good. It rained last, yesterday was a clear day, and it rained last night quite heavily. But it's been a good day by Scottish standards for rugby today. Wind into him, has he got the distance? He's got the direction, and just shaving the side of the upright.
Golde geleentheid voor Zuid-Afrika, daarmee Jan André Joubert, 89 keer voor die Vrystaat ook gespeeld. Rio, ek denk die tactiek van die Springbokke sal wees om die Skotte eerst voorlands mak te maak, maar die Skotte wat baie goed in die losspel is.
Chalmers starts well, the tap down to Patterson is beautifully taken, good tackle by Joost van der Westhuizen on his opposite number. Big day for Derek Patterson. Always difficult for a scrum half. It's such a pressure position making his debut. And Joost van der Westhuizen, from a South African point of view, let's hope that he will continue his try-scoring record. First put in for Uli Schmidt. Goes deep to Philip Skutter. It's tapped down on the Scottish side. This is Chalmers. The Scottish crowd get behind the Scottish players. Van der Westhuizen is back for a Chalmers. Was up quickly. Good play by Chester Williams. No advantage to South Africa. There was a knock-on by Scotland. Well, I think we're going to see a lot of that from Scotland today. Those up-and-unders. The forwards just will want to sort each other out very early on. Let's try and get an ascendancy in the front row. Van der Westhuizen. Patterson was up quickly. So was MacIver. Gavin Hastings, his first touch of the ball. And it goes out on the full, so there'll be a line-out way back in Scottish territory.
Joost van der Westhuizen het tot dusver 2 skoppe gegee in die wedstrijd. Beide was baie goed geweest. 'N kaptein van die Britse Leeuws verlede jaar in New Zealand, Gavin Hastings. 6 voet 2 duim lang.
His 51st cap today.
En vandaag die 10e keer wat hij Schotland aanvoert. Dolly Ware.
Philip Skutter at the back of the line-out. He moves up close and now taps it down. It was Morrison who came through very quickly. Morrison's a tear-away flank forward. Scotland side of Wannock. This is Chalmers having to use the left foot. And the touch judge just deciding that the ball was over the line. That's Steve Hilditch, the man who was the referee against Swansea when South Africa had that incredible win.
Suid-Afrika wat nou reeds by 2 geleenthede op hulle eie ingooi die bal verloor het in die lynstande. Craig Chalmers.
Quite interesting to see Philip Skutter using the tap at number 4 in the line-out. Now it's Richardson and Reed. Andrew Reed, also a tall guy. Patterson handles well. Chalmers getting it away to Shield. Can't get past Henny LaRue though. That's a good tackle. The Scottish rucking and mauling techniques are extremely good. Referee says the South Africans are coming through too early. But coming through on the wrong side as that ball came out. You see Gavin Hastings right in there amongst his players. Very, very popular captain of Scotland, Craig Chalmers.
Chalmers, wat sy debuut vir Wallis in 19, of althans vir Scotland in 1989 gemaak het.
Well, that kick was with the wind. And now Scotland for the first time into South African 22-meter area.
Dinge lol in die lijn staan aan jou. Kom ons kyk of die Springbok hulle swak bal kan besok.
Richardson is at forward. He taps down nice. He's taken in by Alan Sharp. Quick help from Morrison. And this is where Scotland are very powerful. Now Chalmers, Shield, Hastings coming in. Great tackle by Ruben Prieur. Well, that was fabulous defense by the Springbok number 7. In fact, I think he just got up there, just sort of moving his arm around. I think he hurt his shoulder a little bit because Gavin Hastings, a big guy, came in at pace.
Skerp beweging met Gavin Hastings, maar hy loop hom vas teen Pieter Hendricks en Ruben Kreur. Uitstekende verdediging en die skop van Henny LaRue, een lang skop. En dan weer teruggeval word aan die oorkant. Die Springbokke Chester Williams wat by is.
Now that's where South Africa will have to kick for those angles. They must kick for the space. Tony Stanger, the try scorer when Scotland won the Grand Slam in 1990 when Scotland beat England.
Springbokke wat vooraf was gunstig beskou om hierdie toets te wen, want Scotland het nou 8 keer agtereenvolgens verloor.
Mark Andrews up front, difficult ball for Joost van der Westhuizen. Mullen was through very quickly. Well, Philip Skutter will very quickly realise, although he's played a number of times in that Springbok jersey, that the pace of test match rugby is just that couple of metres quicker. First test match today, Mullen. Richardson got high. Patterson, Chalmers, the skip pass to Scott Hastings. He almost gets through the gap, but again, Henny LaRue makes the stop. Morrison was in, that's good winning of the ball, and Henny LaRue moves it wide to Yapi Mulder. This is Pieter Hendricks inside to Uli Schmidt. He gets moved backwards in the tackle. Van der Westhuizen handles well. This is Francois Pienaar. Very quickly in there is Osturant, who's really one of the finds of the tour, penalty to South Africa.
Hier ons het weer baie goeie spel gesien van Ruben Kreur. Maar ook Francois Pienaar het besef dat Henny LaRue was in 'n swakker posisie, die bal behou. En die resultaat dan 'n strafskop aan Suid-Afrika. Dolly Ware, wat voorheen baie rugby vir Skotland op slot gespeel het. 14 toetse as slot, vandag.
Well, he had the distance, but not the direction.
Twee geleenthede is verby vir Suid-Afrika om die voortou te neem.
André Joubert, who had such a great game for the Barbarians against Scotland in the centenary game on this very ground. Chalmers. Mark Andrews goes high. Jos van der Beste is in good hands. He'll have to chase onto that very quickly because Gavin Hastings is there. Referee saying that Francois Pienaar was offside.
Gavin Hastings in beeld 466 punte in 50 toetse. Ons het nou die aand na 'n video gekyk hier waar Matt Doyle opgetree het in 'n vyf nasie wedstryd. Dit lyk vir ons of hy nie baie daarvan hou om die spelers in die lyn saam te straf nie, maar hy laat die voordeel baie goed toe.
There's Her Royal Highness, the Princess Royal, Princess Anne. She did the opening ceremony, taken in there by Richardson. Patterson using the upper number for the first time. Peter Hendricks is bowled over unceremoniously by Kenny Logan, but it was too early.
Ligting strafskop toegeken aan die Springbokke. Pieter Hendricks wat spring vir hom en die reël bepaal dat wanneer jy in die lug is, kan 'n speler jou nie grond toe bring nie. En 'n goeie beslissing deur Matt Doyle, maar hoe veroelie hulle dit op hier in die voorgrond? Ongelukkig gaan ons dit nie sien nie. Maar hierdie verligting strafskop van die Springbokke wat die Springbokke weer binne die gebied bring van Skotland. Daardie weer.
Skutter, he enjoyed that. Watch how Osturant goes in. Mark Andrews, but the Scots go very low now. South Africa have managed to change the direction. Ruben Clear also working hard. Counter shot back MacIver. South Africa will be disappointed if they lose us. Van der Beste says, and now Willie Schwan. Now Henny Leroux gets over the advantage line. Can he move it back? MacIver jumped over and got the ball very quickly. Now Durant. The other Springboks will have to come around. This is Van der Beste and the chase coming from Peter Hendricks and Gavin Hastings getting his clearance in. André Joubert will have to make a lot of ground here. Gavin Hastings is there. André Joubert does well to get around him.
Briljante spel deur die Springbok hier agter. Spok met 'n beekom graad André Joubert. Maar Gavin Hastings baie ervare. Sy debuut vir Skotland in 1986 gemaak, maar hou vir André Joubert op. Klop daar vir Gavin Hastings en 'n baie goeie skop.
In the front row of Scotland, Kenny Milne, 31st test, and Paul Burnell, his 37th test, so there's a lot of experience there. You see the body positions of the Scottish, they get very low. There's good work by Philip Skutter, Patterson, now Chalmers. Big chase by Hastings and Shiel. André Joubert couldn't hold on. Chalmers is there. And now a chance for Tony Stanger at Dawn. It's a brilliant tackle by Chester Williams. Tony Stanger and Jos van der Beste and gets it to Henny Leroux. Well, that's very welcome relief for South Africa. That was a great up and under, well chased.
André Joubert wat nie naby die bal kom nie, die bal wat gunstig spring vir die Skotte. Tony Steinger, maar hou vir Chester Williams dop, laag om die enkels, hy het ook vir John Kirwan so grond toe gebring. En met Chester Williams' verdediging is daar niks meer verkeerd nie.
And you saw number 14 across there as well, Peter Hendricks doing great cover. He was the guy who secured the ball after that tackle by Chester Williams.
Vir die kykers wat so pas ingeskakel het, 15 minute verstreek in die eerste helft, die telling nog 0-0.
Morrison gets the tap down on the Scottish side. Now they'll work it. McCarver's working it back. This is Scott Hastings. Took his eyes off the ball. Very quickly there was Jaapie Mulder. You'll notice that Jaapie Mulder, when he comes into picture, has got a bandage on his left leg. And he's been battling with that. That's Scott Hastings. And amazing today that both brothers playing their 51st test match.
Gavin Hastings, of althans Scott Hastings, van aan die wereldrekord hou van 28 toetse as 'n senterkombinasie met Sean Lennon.
Good scrum by South Africa, André Joubert so often on this tour moving that way. Gavin Hastings has obviously watched some videos of South Africa play. And it's quite interesting. I would say that right now, if there's any wind, it could be favouring South Africa a little bit. Toured South Africa a couple of times, but not as a player. Played, in fact, in Nas Buerta's farewell game. Nas will remember that. Willie Schmidt with the throw. Mark Andrews got the tap. Joost van der Westhuizen is scragged by Doddy Weir. Chester Williams. Back for it is Stanger. And Stanger made the catch. I think he could have probably left that.
Goeie skop van Chester Williams. Chester, wat reeds 8 toetse vir Suid-Afrika gespeel het, spog met 3 toets 3. Sy teenstander Tony Stanger, 35 toetse, 15-3 in die proces. Maar die Springbokke is nou binnen kan die kwartgebied van Skotland. En nou is het belangrijk dat Oli Schmid sy springers moet vind. En die Springbokke sukkel tot dusver in die lijnstaande. En die Skotters beter klaar met hulle balretensie.
Once again, it's deep to Philip Skutter. He's used the tap a number of times. You see how quickly Morrison was onto that ball. And Scottish loose forward sees on any opportunity very quickly. Great clearance by Derek Patterson.
Kommerwekkend ons lijnstaand spel. Slordige besit wat aan Joost van der Westhuizen gegee word.
Well, it was that man, Ian Morrison, who got through very quickly onto the tap ball. So maybe Philip Skutter will have to think about going up for the two-handed catch. That was Mark Andrews, nicely down into the middle. That's better weight. Gavin Hastings. Oh, and Sanger just taking his time. Hastings forced onto his weak foot. But that's a very good clearance by Gavin Hastings. And good work by Tony Stanger. Took it a little bit casually initially, but managed to get it away to Gavin Hastings.
So, byna was daar probleme vir die Skotte. Stanger wat die bal met een hand in die handen kry. André Joubert ongelukkig hartloop verby Hastings. Willems die man wat druk toepas. En een skop in die linkervoet van Hastings. Uitbuit kan die kwartgebied van Skotland.
Is taken down by Kenny Milne. Gainry handling very swift. Chalmers has to move it back to Scott Hastings, the long one to his brother. André Joubert is perfectly positioned. Can he now counter-attack? He's got Logan coming up in defense. Gavin Hastings now, having played, Peter Muller goes, and Gavin Hastings is going to be in trouble. Peter Muller went into Gavin Hastings a little bit with the knees there.
Weer so'n bietjie geluk aan die kant van Skotland. Gavin Hastings onder groot.
Willie Schmidt trying to keep it in play. Rudolf Stahli does well. This is van der Westhuizen. Then I tell you, Morrison is tackling like an absolute Trojan. Peter Hendricks is there in the scrum half position. Gets it away to Henny LaRue. Now to Peter Muller. Strong running by the big centre. Willie Schmidt goes in. Now taken on by Peter Durant. Now Philip Skutter, this is Uli Schmidt, this is good play by the South Africa. They get it on the inside, Ruben Clear, the loose forwards working beautifully in tandem. Joost van der Westhuizen once again, André Joubert, Chase Chester Williams, and across goes Scott Hastings. That was good play by the Green and Golds.
André Joubert wat in die achterlijn gespring het. Hy het gesien dat hy die bal nie vir Chester Williams kon gee nie. Slim hou hy om laag op die grond en die Springbokke is 5 meter weg van die doellijn van Skotland.
And there are hundreds of South African supporters here. So many of them said, please. That's Alan Reid. They've changed round their numbers. Patterson. And nicely played. But no, it's not out. Chester Williams. Got André Joubert with him. That's good running by Chester Williams as he stays on his feet. Moves into the Scottish 22-meter area. Great ball for Van der Westhuizen. And now LaRue. Bit of a mix-up there. It's one of the Scottish guys grabbed it. Now the referee says play on. Everybody paying for offside. Watch Ruben Clear. Yanked this ball out. Well, the referee just saying it wasn't going to come out. The South Africa attacking their ball.
Willie Smith, vriendelijke kerel. Maar hier is een belangrijke scrum voor Zuid-Afrika. Van hier die positie kan ons aanvallen. Ons is binnenkant die kwartgebied.
23 minutes now gone. Still no score. South Africa with just the two opportunities at goal. Both long penalty attempts by André Joubert. Both just shaving the uprights. It's important that they keep this scrum up now. Rudolf Schaali, Ruben Krier couldn't hold on. Once again, the referee saying, you see that number seven for Scotland, Ian Morrison, is working incredibly hard.
Rudolf Stroyle, over Tian Strauss at the toetspan uit.
Now, all the Springbok backs are on this side of the field, nearest the camera. Will they work it on the short side? That's a good scrum by Scotland, front of Vesthuizen. Now the dummy run, this is Yapi Muller. He's well tackled by Shiel. And Peter Hendricks picked the ball up very quickly. Peter Muller it was who picked it up very quickly.
South Africa, that for 80 minutes on the concentrate. Moet zeker maken van die aangee. Nie hanteerfoute op sulke kritieke stadiums kan bekostig nie.
Well, it's the cut and thrust of test match football, and those Scottish centres will know that they've been in a game. Great scrum by South Africa. Good counter shot by the Scottish loose forwards once more. See Doddy Ware working very hard. Derek Patterson is in there. Philip Skutter goes in hard. This is Chalmers. Well, it was a great scrum by South Africa. Obviously an eight-man shove, and the Scottish pack disintegrated.
Die Skotte is bietjie bekommerd oor Craig Chalmers. Hulle sê vir my dat hulle nie altyd baie goed onder druk vaar nie. Maar kom ons kyk of dit nou beter met die Springbok in die lijn staan gaan.
You can see the difference in percentage. Better for Scotland. The interesting to see, there's such a great understanding between Willie Schmidt and Mark Andrews. There it is. Now, Van der Vesthuizen is in close. Henny LaRue. Now the big charge by Peter Muller. Good tackle again by Morrison. South Africa, the ball was on the ground. South Africa going forward. That man again, Morrison, making the tackle close in. Might be in South Africa's interest to move the ball a little bit wider. Peter Muller coming through. He's a big man for an international centre. Now, Rudolf Schaali finds Joost van der Vesthuizen. Henny LaRue is on the inside. This is Peter Hendricks. He's got a bit of room to move. Chalmers makes the tackle. Well laid back. A foot getting in the way there. This is Henny LaRue. Oh, this is a real test as Gavin Tastings gets back. In goes Yapi Mulder. Now, can they work the ball back? And it's well worked back. Oh, it's dropped in the in-goal area by Scott Hastings.
Scott Hastings in beeld. Maar so byna was Yapi Mulder daar oor die doelijn. Hy kry hom in die hande, maar vol punte vir Skotlandse verdediging.
You see how Graham Shiel went in there. Now the crowd getting behind the South African players because there are a lot of South Africans there. Quickly into the scrum goes Peter Muller.
Kracht center. In 1992 is debuut in die All Blacks vir Suid-Afrika gemaak. En dit 'n lol hier in die diskant hier.
Yeah, but the thing is, one must understand that it's not in South Africa's interest to collapse the scrum. The referee just calling Sharp and Tommy Loubsha over.
Mens kan sien wat gebiedsvoordeel betref vir Suid-Afrika beter daarin toe. Maar die Springbokke moet hulle kansen benut. Tommy Loubsha, wat vandag in sy derde toets vir Suid-Afrika speel teen Sharp, wat reeds 5 toetse gespeel het. Sharp, 'n bouer van beroep, kom ons hou sake dop.
Now, Tommy Loach has got to give a strong right hand there. Now, Peter Muller gets into the scrum.
Kijk, waar staan André Joubert? Hier is Hollands Pieter Hendricks.
Now, how is the referee going to decide? Who's pushing in, who's pushing out? Very difficult situation. I cannot understand that. Because South Africa are not... As I say, it was not in their interest to make an infringement at the scrum.
Hierdie is slegs 'n vryskop. So Suid-Afrika kry weer geleentheid om die bal by die lynstaan in te gooi.
Hey, there by Francois Pienaar and by Oost-Durant. Joost van der Westhuizen says, come and grab the ball. I can't take it. Pienaar works hard. Nicely laid back. Now taken on by Ruben Creel. South Africa still camped down near the Scottish 22-meter area. Henny Leroux. Now Francois Pienaar. Good tackling again by the Scottish loose forwards. So they're finding it tough. Henny Leroux getting the pass away to Chester Williams. This is under Yabert. He gets around Tony Stanger. He just couldn't find Chester Williams on the outside, inside. He got around Tony Stanger beautifully there, did under Yabert.
Goeie verdediging deur Skotland, maar André Joubert wat die bal kry van Chester Williams, hou hom dop eers binne en dan buite. Laat Versteinger vir 'n oomblik aarzel. André Joubert nou die laaste belangrike aangee verby Chester Williams en Suid-Afrika miskien ongelukkig om nie punt aan te teken nie. Maar Suid-Afrika is op die aanval. Binne kan die kwartgebied van Skotland nog geen telling nie.
Tony Stanger did it well to eventually drag André Joubert down. This is just van der Westhuizen. Has he got space to find Willie Schmitz going hard for the line? And again, Patterson, who's a small man, makes an extremely good tackle. Now, 5 meters from the Scottish line. The most experienced South African on the test pitch today, Willie Schmitz. That's a good jump there by Richardson. Patterson, Chalmers. He hasn't found his touch. Back for it is. Oh no, South Africans are letting the ball bounce. That was a bad mistake. Stanger goes in quickly. Bit of a misunderstanding there between Francois Pienaar and Chester Williams.
Val deur Stoop. Hy's oor.
Well, it was very important for South Africa to score at that time. Territorially, they've had by far the better of the first 32 minutes of the game. And it was important, André Joubert having missed with two more difficult kicks than that. But he's playing well in the open field, and he will, his confidence will have been hugely boosted by that three-pointer. South Africa playing with more and more confidence. Great catch by Mark Andrews. Van der Westhuizen, Joubert.
Interessant hoe hy daardie bal gekry op sy regtervoet. Ander Joubert wat baie daar hard daaraan werk om met beide voete te skop. Eindelike man wat daarvan hou om met sy linkervoet te skop, Ander Joubert. Ander Joubert wat nou reeds 64 punte op hierdie toer aangeteken het. Maar jy's reg, Joos, jy sê dat die Springbokke, hoe langer hierdie helfte duur, al beter begin speel. En dit gee mens baie het vertroue vir die tweede helfte.
Good catch there by Richardson at the front of the line-out. Patterson, now Chalmers. They haven't moved the ball down the line too often under Joubert. Shield is up there quickly. Good catch by Joubert. Must stand up in the tackle. Chester Williams comes around and supports beautifully. Van der Westhuizen. Now Henny Leroux. Oh, and Henny Leroux connected that one. It's a beautiful kick.
Well, you, that was a skitterende skop van Henny Leroux. Hy het die bal onder druk gekry. En met hierdie skop is Suid-Afrika net buitekant die kwartgebied van Skotland.
Well, even Gavin Hastings was caught unawares. That ball going way over his head. And one must say that following that kick, this wind seems to now be blowing a little bit across the field, so really favouring neither side in any particular way. Referee quite rightly having a word with Alan Sharp, who was just pushing into Mark Andrews. Alan Sharp, apart from Richardson, who's making his debut, the least experienced member of the Scottish pack. Tapped down there by Francois Pienaar. Now Joost van der Westhuizen, but it was the outside arm. Francois Pienaar jumping up with the right arm.
Joost van der Westhuizen, vandaag zijn 6e toets. In die 5 toetse wat hy gespeel het, het hy dusver 3-3 gedruk. En is verbaasend hoeveel 3 hierdie man druk, Joos van der Westhuizen. Ook Suid-Afrikaanse kleure vir korfbal.
His father, Gustav, is also here on tour. Nice catch there by André Joubert. Ooh, and André Joubert has connected that one as well. It's a huge punt. And that is absolutely brilliant. The touch judge's flag is still down. Stanger does the cleaning up.
Wel, jy, daar die bal het lugfoto's van Murrayfield geneem.
Little unfortunate for South Africa that that ball didn't bounce right, but Tony Stanger was well back and had it covered. Now, Craig Chalmers, man that we've watched in Five Nations Rugby a great deal over the years, Mark Andrews, he's doing great work, so is this man Ruben Creer, and Paul Sturant right behind him now, Van der Westhuizen. South Africa winning the ball well, strong running, great tackle by MacIver for Scotland. Francois Pienaar was the man who carried it in. Sharp again seems to just be looking for a bit of trouble. Does Sharp now? Yapi Mulder now. André Joubert got a little bit of room. And Chester Williams gets on the inside there of Tony Stanger, but he's brought down by Hastings. South Africa still winning a surfeit of ball. It's a good play again now. Durant, they've got to drive in and keep the pressure up, as does Ruben Creel. Willie Schmidt right on his shoulder. Peter Muller. Morrison having a bit of an argument there.
Pieter Muller, altyd baie kompeterend. Meneer Doyle wat nou gaan gesels. Meneer Doyle wat verlede jaar africhtingslinieke verskeidsrechters in Suid-Afrika gehoud. Maar hoe van André Joubert op Slimtorp?
Again, it's a solid scrummage. That's well read by Joos van der Westhuizen. He makes it again! He makes it again! Fourth try in 5 test matches. It's unbelievable.
Ongelooflik, vreugde vir die Suid-Afrikaanse ondersteuners. Dit het eers gelyk of hy die verkeerde opsie geneem het. Een mens wou sê, Joos, keer die bal uit vir die agterlyn. Maar sy 4de toets 3 in 6 toetse.
But just watch how well he sums this up, Johnny. Look at that. He still has the scrum wheels. He saw his opportunity. Watch those long legs just move. He gives himself room. And what a fabulous break. He'd read it so well as the scrum wheeled.
Hy het besluit, hierdie is myne. Niemand gaan my keer nie. Kyk na sy gesig, die vasberadenheid.
En prachtig, die eerste 3 na 1965 op Murrayfield gedruk deur Joos van der Westhuizen van Noordtrans.
Van der Westhuizen, the opportunity under your bears. Fourth attempted goal is unsuccessful, so he's missed 3 out of 4 now. And he won't be happy with that.
Hierdie voorsprong is wel verdiend. André Joubert, daar was so bietjie kommer oor, hy sou sissel teen die hoë balle.
You see number 6, MacIver had moved away. His man was Joost van der Westhuizen, and he'll be very disappointed that he moved out on the wrong side of the scrum. Again, terrific catch by Mark Andrews. Ruben Creer works hard. Philip Skitter helps. Now André Joubert. Chester Williams giving chase. Beautifully taken by Gavin Hastings. He's got Stanger on his inside. Chester holds him up. Stanger takes well. He's heavily dumped by a lot of South African players. Now Patterson. Gavin Hastings goes in as well. Peter Muller was working hard on defence. MacIver goes and secures the possession for Scotland. See his body position as he pushes it back to Patterson. Now Hastings, he's up there thinking that I must help my team out. Patterson, Chalmers. Shield and Yapi Mulder are there. This is good play now by Scott Hastings. Again, good work by the Scottish Packer forwards. Beautiful ball for Patterson. This is Shield. Runs into both Henny Leroux and Francois Pienaar. Now can they hold him up as Scotland will strive to get this ball back. Now Joos van der Westhuizen gets it, moves it away to André Joubert. There's no fullback there. Chester Williams gives chase. So it is Chalmers. So it is Logan. Logan secured. This is great play by Logan. Can he get away from Peter Hendricks? Kenny Logan did brilliantly there.
Logan, dit was gevaarlik, want Chester Williams het hom gejaag. Hou vir Chester Williams dop. Logan, kyk met die een hand, briljant tel hy die bal op. Of die verkeerde voet is Chester Williams. Pieter Hendricks wat hom jaag.
You see how he straightened Peter Hendricks up and then just got that kick in away. Terrific play by the Scottish left wing. Stirling County, who are top of the Scottish League.
Morgan, wat reeds 1-3 vir Skotland in toetse gedruk het. Belangrike lynstand vir die Springbokke.
Philip Skutter got the tap. That's good play again. The South African forwards are working well. Interesting to see Henny LaRue just lose his footing there, quickly taken by Logan. Oh, the touch judge pulled his flag down. For a moment he pulled his flag down and then he put it up again. Could have been a controversial decision there by Steve Hilditch. See the Owen Doyle, the referee, just smiling, I think rather in sympathy.
Maar wat baie bemoedigend is, is die feit dat Henny LaRue vandag die kantlyn haal.
Now just look at that in terms of territory and possession. Great work after a shaky start by the line-up forwards. This is good forward play by Scotland. Doddy Weir is in there very hard. Now Chalmers, Shiel, and a little skip to Gavin Hastings. This is Logan. He's up in the line. This is great running. Can he get Stanger away? Stanger lost it forward. Referee waiting for advantage. Peter Hendricks gets under the tackle and then makes the clearance. But the referee, you can see right in the middle of your picture, calling them back for the scrummage. His great hands by Gavin Hastings and then Kenny Logan really making his presence felt on this field. There he is in possession.
Kom ons kyk na die verdediging. Dis die man wat hom vasvat. Henny LaRue van agteraf. Dis een ding waarmee die Suid-Afrikaners beïndruk op hierdie toer en dit is met hulle verdediging.
Well cleared there by Joost van der Westhuizen under a lot of pressure and Henny LaRue did well to get that so far.
Suid-Afrika het nou hierdie voorsprong. Hulle gaan baie selfvertroue hê as hulle die tweede helfte binne gaan, so hulle kan net voortbou op hierdie voorsprong. Maar ons kon baie verder voorgeloop het hier.
Well, it'll be interesting to see whether Scotland move the ball wide because they will have been encouraged by the fact that they made such ground moving the ball wide. We've seen Chalmers doing the up and under most of the game, but the first time they moved it wide, they certainly gained an awful lot of ground. Van der Westhuizen and Morrison nearly got the interception. Yapi Mulder getting Peter Muller away. Hastings, all the time in the world to make his clearance. Yes, he brings them back for the scrum on the centre spot. Now, Scotland will want to come back very strongly right now. South Africa have to keep up their motivation and concentration. Their forwards have been controlling possession and territory beautifully. Rudolf Charlie just moving that ball. You see it's already gone 5 metres, but they won't want to lose it. Well, the scrum moved through the 30 degrees, but you can see the ground that South Africa have made on them there, about fully five metres. But it's that type of control that they want to be careful, because now what they must do is get the ball out and kick for the corners. Andre Joubert does so. Just kicking for position. Hastings, Williams was up quickly, and the fact that Hastings picked up the ball means it's South Africa's throw in.
Weer baie goeie spel van Chester Williams. Hy jaag die bal en hy doen daar vir Gavin Hastings, die helfte van Skotland, in 'n fout in. En die resultaat is dat Suid-Afrika se Ollie Smith die bal wil kan gooi by die lyn staan.
The tall man, Doddy Weir, has moved right to the front of the line-out. He's the number 8. He's just on 2 metres tall. Philip Skutter. Chris Richardson, who came across. Reed, who came across very quickly. Now, can South Africa move this ball out? Van der Westhuizen trying to get it back. He works well. And he gets through. Yes, Van der Westhuizen. I don't believe it. He's done it again. He's done it again.
Joost van der Westhuizen in die groen en goud. Nou sy naam gaan môre in goud geskryf word. Maak Andrews baie bly. Maar is ongelooflik hierdie man se werkstempo. Hy kan dit eintlik self nie glo nie en al wat ons kan sê, wel gedaan Joost van der Westhuizen.
No South African scrum half has ever scored two tries in a test match.
Hou hom dop. Kyk hoe laag gaan hy nou in as hy vasgevat word. Daar is hy laag, kop omlaag. Nou soek hy ondersteuning. Hy besef ondersteuning is nie daar nie. En Murrayfield sal onthou word deur Joos van der Westhuizen.
Oh, and Father Gustav is jumping around. I mean, I can't just looking around for some to see somebody who must be jumping 15 feet in the air. And Andre Joubert's conversion kick. I haven't seen the scoreboard move because we missed it on the slow motion there. Andre Joubert's conversion kick was successful. 15 points to nil, South Africa lead.
Jou, dis die type van begin wat Suid-Afrika wou gehad het. Maar Joos van der Westhuizen, hy breek daar weg van ondersteuning. Swakkerige verdediging aan Skotland se kant. En kyk hoe plant hy daar die bal. Maar dis 'n goeie fundament vir die tweede helfte wat gelê is deur Suid-Afrika. En van hier af kan Suid-Afrika voortbou.
Well, they're playing with so much confidence now. Henny LaRue gets it away to Yapi Mulder. And Peter Hendricks couldn't hold on. Expansive rugby by the South Africans. Now Yapi Hendricks gets through. Ball taken there by Morrison. South Africa mustn't get too overconfident. Patterson, great tackle by Francois Pienaar. Taken on by Rudolph Charlie. Oh, he wins the possession. Beautifully helped from Ruben Trier, who does great work, as does Mark Andrews. This is great play by South Africa once again, moving it wide under Joubert. Can he lead away? Now it's Ali Schmidt. Shiel comes in for the tackle. Peter Muller makes a pickup. Desperate defence by the Scots. And there was a knock on by South Africa, but it was great defence by the Scottish outside backs. Shiel in particular made a great tackle on Ali Schmidt.
Een ding wil ek vir jou sê, jou Ruben Kruger, wat baie goeie besit vir die Springbokke verseker in die losspel. Andre Joubert in die agterlyn en dan Ali Schmidt op regter vleuel. Kyk na die goeie verdediging op hom om die middellyf en dit veroorsaak dat die bal lospad en dat Skotland die bal kan gooi by die vaste skrip.
Well, are South Africa getting into a position now where they can run these Scottish people ragged, because the Scottish defence is absolutely desperate and South Africa playing with so much more confidence. Look at the scrums awarded to South Africa. Huge kick by Chalmers, hasn't found the touch. This is Peter Hendricks. Everything going well at the moment. Gavin Hastings is hurtling across the field in desperate defence. Now he's right up against the touchline. He's not particularly strong with the left foot. Chester Williams makes a great tackle.
Gavin Hastings lyk vir my so bietjie stadig. Dit lyk vir my of hy 'n trio wat verloor het deur die jare.
That's the test referee, Steve Hilditch, the man who let the game flow so well at Swansea. Watch that man, number one, Osturan, 22 years old only. He's got a great future in front of him. This is Francois Pienaar, desperate tackle by Doddy Weir. Now Van der Westhuizen, beautifully hands there by Henny LaRue, and look at that from Rudolph Charlie. And Chester Williams will make it for the five-pointer. Oh, the boys are playing wonderful rugby, and look how delighted Chester is. All his tries before have been against Argentina, and now he gets one against a major IRB country.
Kyk na hierdie drie. Andre Joubert, die argitek, hardloop in die gaping in. Strooi hy daar met sy ondersteunende spel. En kyk hoe mooi Chester Williams dit gelees. Hy hardloop in daardie gaping in. En sy oom Avril Williams gaan baie, baie trots voel op hom. Maar dis 'n slim aangee vir Andre Joubert. Strooi is daar, die skakel. En Chester Williams druk 'n drie. En hy druk sy vierde toets drie op Murrayfield. Andre Joubert, die Springbokke wat nou gerieflik voorloop met 25 punte teenoor 0. 1951-44-0. Is nou 20, excuse you. Goeie skop van Andre Joubert.
Yes, and the two-pointer is there. 22 points to nil, South Africa lead, and they are playing fantastic rugby at the moment. This is expansive football, and let's give the Scottish crowd full marks. They really do appreciate it.
Die Springbokke wat nou 15 man rugby speel. Andre Joubert, kyk hoe netjies hou hy sy hande bo die laagvat. Rudolph Stroyli, en dan soos ek gesê het, Chester Williams wat homself in posisie in hardloop. Hy hardloop homself in die gaping in. Pragtige drie vir die Springbokspan. Andre Joubert op die linkervoet.
Well, that is what's happening, is Andre Joubert is just moving into position. What South Africa are doing so well today, and Naas Botha will love this, is that they're kicking for position far more than they've done in previous test matches.
Wat gebeur het hier is dat Suid-Afrika die spel so bietjie stadiger gemaak het, hulle die bal bietjie langer onder die voorspelers begin hou en die resultaat is op die tafel.
Desperate tap there by Jeremy Richardson, and they lose the possession. Henny Larue, now Ruben Krier. They have to bring it up tight again. Another ball for Van der Vestas, and he's having a fabulous game. Francois Pienaar makes those dashes to pull in the defence. And Trudeau, look at that, how just Van der Vestas has got his hands above the tackle. And the big man, Philip Skitty, is like the Carlton centre bearing down on the desperate blue jerseys. Oh, this is Rudolph Charlie, and he will get it for the top. Oh, this is fabulous. This is fabulous, fabulous, fabulous.
Rudolf Joudoring, sy vierde toets, sy derde toets drie. En glo my, die Skotte begin hierdie rugby geniet wat Suid-Afrika nou speel. Maar dis voorlands waar het begin. Suid-Afrika se balretensie is goed, hulle losspel is goed. Henny Leroux, Rudolf Stroyli, en kyk hoe hard loop hierdie man vir 'n doellyn. Niemand gaan omkeer nie.
Just see how the set up there by Henny Leroux. I mean, he dragged all the defence. The defence was desperate. And that man getting across, Andrew Reid, I mean, that's just so desperate. They're just not getting the possession. South Africa playing with so much confidence. But set up, I must say, by the front five. Durant, Schmidt, Loebscher, Andrews and Skutter. They're playing fabulously. Andre Joubert's kick rather wide.
Mens begin opmerk dat die Skotse voorspelers ook nou baie stadiger kom by die afbreekpunte.
Well, I can tell you who's here today, and that's Joel Arterfun. As again, we see how Henny Leroux just drew the defence. Look at Stanger, he doesn't know what to do. The big man just thunders him. Remember his try in New Zealand, now he's done it again. And Hans, you can sit down now if you're back in Pretoria. I'm surprised that you're not here.
Groot klomp Suid-Afrikaanse ondersteuners wat vanaand gaan feesvier. Mens moet nie te gou begin praat nie, maar 27-0 is in 'n toetswedstryd eintlik 'n wenvoorsprong.
Well, we have still got more than 30 minutes to go. In fact, just on 30 minutes to go in this game. That's a good tap down. Well caught in there by Richardson. Francois Pienaar made the initial stop. This is Patterson. Now Chalmers. Oh, he gets Logan away. Logan is full of running. Peter Hendricks got to invent a touch. And I must say that Kenny Logan has shown that he's full of running. Now Scotland roll within the 22-metre area. Good attacking position for them. In fact, of the Scottish backs, I must say that Kenny Logan has been the most impressive. Talking about fathers, Louis will be happy about this, I'm sure. Louis played against the French in 1958, and now Uli in his 16th test match today. Oh, it was beautifully tapped down. You see how Mark Andrews took it at the back of the lineout. Kitch Christie's put so much emphasis on skills at the practices, and all the practices are played at a very high tempo, a high speed tempo, high concentration tempo. Now Scotland working well. Francois Pienaar did well to get the ball back on the South African side. They weren't 10 metres though. This will be the first attempted goal in the entire game for Gavin Hastings.
Dottie Werenbeeld. Hy het reeds 1-3 aangeteken.
We'll be enjoying this as Gavin Hastings puts Scotland on the board.
Bly nog 32 minute oor in die tweede helfte, miskien 'n bietjie minder, so 30 minute. Klomp bekommerde Skotse toeskouers, maar is Suid-Afrika wat hierna rustyd vir Skotland geruk het en pragtige drie aangeteken het. Francois Pienaar weer in die voorpunt, ook Mark Andrews.
That was well taken in by Doddy Ware. Good play again by the Scottish forward. South Africa must just be careful. They don't lose concentration. It's not a good kick by Chalmers. Mark Andrews is under it. He can't hold on. Duddy Ware does. Sharp work there from Allen. Now, Scotland trying desperately to get the ball back. They've got it somewhere in the middle of that thing. Patterson, see again, he just looks up. Uli Schmidt gets back. This is Chester Williams. And it was Scott Hastings who came in very quickly with a tackle. Chester Williams took a little bit of a bump there, but he's a tough guy.
Patterson in beeld, dit was sy grootste ideaal om eendag vir Skotland in 'n toets op Murrayfield te speel. Nou vandag word sy ideaal verweesenlik. Chester Williams, hy besef dat hy die bal nie wild na binne toe moet gee nie. Springbok wil die bal afneem.
Dis Richardson who couldn't hold on from the best days and did well. Peter Hendricks hasn't had too many opportunities today, but look at this for running. And he gets it, I couldn't get around Daddy Ware. Philip Skutter. Oh, he's come on in leaps and bounds as this big man, Philip Skutter, Joost van der Westhuizen, moves it wide. This is Peter Hendricks. He's got men on his outside. Taken now by Jaapie Mulder. Again, the tall scrum half trying to work it back. Philip Skutter is also working hard. A little bit of a mix-up there as to whose ball that's going to be. Scotland win the putting at the short by the inside backs, but the outside guys don't do so well. Hastings on the outside. This is good running around. It was Kenny Logan who came across. Kenny Logan once again showing that he's given an opportunity. He's got pretty deft footwork.
Kom ons hou hierdie beweging dop. Kyk na die verdediging van die Springbokke vorentoe. Kyk na die voorspelers laag aan hulle in. Die stryd ons agter Ruben Kreer, Rudolf Strodi, François Pienaar, Philip Skutte, hoe goed speel hy nie?
One penalty, four tries to South Africa. That was quite blatantly lifting by South Africa. Free kick to Scotland. Patterson will want to take quickly. And he gets it away to McArthur. Great tackle by Ruben Kreer. This is Patterson. Somebody got the ankle tap in there. Scotland will want to get this away. Again, Ruben Kreer is prominent in defence. This is McArthur. Well tackled by Charlie. But you see how well McArthur fell. Chalmers gets it away to Hastings. And then to Tony Stanger. Andre Joubert, what a great tackle by him. The touch judge on the left-hand side of your screen has his flag up. But Scotland moved that ball around very, very quickly.
Kom ons kyk, Gavin Hastings, hardloop in die gaping in. Stanger, Andre Joubert, dis hoe jy man moet vat.
That's a tremendous decision by the touch judge because it was Tony Stanger who didn't get the ball over the goal line. But what defence by Andre Joubert, whom if one had to point out a weakness in Andre Joubert's game, if there is any, it would be in his tackling. But that was a fabulous effort.
Is hierdie bal bedoel vir Mark Andrews?
Nicely taken by François Pienaar. François Pienaar, who's doing so much hard work. South Africa getting low from the best days in Joubert. Well, Scotland now, the last 5 minutes, it's been all Scotland, and they've come back after being that huge 27 points to nil down. Now 27 points to 3 with about 25 minutes still to go.
Ster van die toer. Teen Swansea 38 punte aangeteken. André Joubert.
That's good jumping by the Scottish. Sharp came around very quickly to clean up. It was Andrew Reid who got it at number 4. Now Patterson grovelling for the ball. Ball again being played in fabulous, but super pass from Shield. This is Gavin Hastings, solid defence. Logan again coming around very quickly on the outside. Stanger coming through from the right wing. And this time McIver's working hard. This is good ball for Scotland. Chalmers, he finds Scott Hastings. Look at Henry LaRue's defence. Mulne, now Shield. Shield, who's also been impressive. Scotland drive wide. Now Andre Joubert, he must kick it down the field. Chester Williams gives chase. Gavin Hastings has a long way to go. Gavin Hastings, you're quite right, John. Gavin Hastings has most definitely lost a yard or two in pace.
Chester Williams, reeds 'n 3 aangeteken vandag.
Again, it was great defence by Henny LaRue in midfield that created that loose ball for South Africa.
Maar hier die Suid-Afrikaanse centerpaar, Jaapie Mulder en Pieter Miller, wat baie goed vaar met hulle verdediging in die middenveld. En André Joubert, hy lees die spel so goed.
You're quite right, John. The defense has been good. Deep to Philip Skutter. Look at that for confidence from the 22-year-old. Now Rudolf Staley. The Scottish defense again. They're not making their first time tackles. Van der Veer stays and getting away. Joubert beautifully read by Chester Williams. Oh, look at the man run. Now Willie Switch. He's got the opportunity. He's difficult to bring down. He's saved about a yard or two from the line. Van der Veer stays and can't make it a hat-trick. McIver surely must be offside there. Fed out by Rebentrier. Now Jaapie Mulder.
By 3 for Jaapie Mulder. Jaapie Mulder, sy oom Boet, in 1965, ook 'n Springbok gewees. Hierdie telling 32-3.
Well, Skip Henderson is old headmaster. Now, Skip, take it easy. Take it easy. You'll have a heart attack, Skip. Watch this as he stretches over the line and bashes it over the whitewash.
Wel verdiende 3. Maar dis Ruben Kruger wat sien dat Joos van der Westhuizen is buite posisie. Henny Leroux en dan Jaapie Mulder vang die Skotse verdedigers op die verkeerde voet. Sy momentum wat hom oordra en die skeisregter pragtige positioneer. 32-3. Ek glo my binne in daai borskas klop daai hart baie lekker. André Joubert, hierdie ene makliker een.
And just right at the bottom of your picture just a moment ago, Frans Verster was having a look at Philip Skutter. André Joubert.
André Joubert. Nog 2 punte by vir Suid-Afrika. En hierdie telling is 'n groot telling. Die punte verskil 31. Maar kom ons kyk weer na hierdie 3. Die Skotte, kyk hoe stadig kom hulle nou aangedraf. En Jaapie Mulder. Wat 'n 3 druk vir Suid-Afrika. Oorgestuur na Joos van der Westhuizen.
Very quickly tackled by David McCarver. Now there's a bit of a wrestling match going on, and that's a pity because this game has played in great spirit. And Mark Andrews is not inclined to go on the dirty side. One must understand that. Maybe a little bit of frustration creeping in on the Scottish side. It was Doddy Weir who was the man tangling with him.
Nou sou dit interessant wees om te sien of die skeisregter sy beslissing gaan verander. Hy het 'n strafskop toegeken aan Suid-Afrika. Mark Andrews wat in die laaste 10 minute van die eerste helfte en in die eerste 20 minute van die tweede helfte uitstekend vir Suid-Afrika gevaar het in die lyn staan hè. Jan Engelbreg die spanbestuurder. Hans om Prinses Anne. André Joubert met die linkervoet. Suid-Afrika se voorspelers wat in die tweede helfte die inisiatief oorgeneem het. Is opmerklik dat Suid-Afrika hulle los voorspelers gebruik om tweede fase af te dwing en van daar af speel die Springbokke en skep hulle hulle self vir hulle self gapings.
3 goals, 2 tries, 1 penalty, 34 points to 3. Gosh, and I was looking at some of the guys, Scott Berger and George Rotenbach, and their party of tourists last night, and I can assure you that nobody had a score near to 34 points to 3.
Ook opmerklik hier dat die Skotse losgespelers nou ingetrek word met hierdie bewegings waar die Springbokke gebruik deur François Pina dan aan die bal beskikbaar stel vir Joos van der Westhuizen en die bal daar vooruit.
Well, François Pina has now been used extensively as a line-out forward and he does it so well. Jaapie Mulder now full of confidence. Look at Ruben Kruger, he's in there on McIver. Joos van der Westhuizen is up quickly. Now Henny Leroux and André Joubert finds Peter Hendricks on the inside. They'll want to keep this ball alive again. You see the blue shirts desperately having to defend. They've been dragged in. Van der Westhuizen getting Joubert away. He couldn't find Van der Westhuizen as he had seen Peter Muller coming in. Peter Muller would have been straight into the gap. But again, the blues, the dark blue shirts, it's desperate defense.
André Joubert ongelukkig is swak aangee op die tone van Joos van der Westhuizen. En so byna was dit nommer 3 vir Joos.
A lot of pressure coming, but Ruben Kruger came off the side of the scrum too early. South Africa seemed to have found their confidence and concentration once again. I can tell you people at home that a guy like Peter Durant, if you look through the Springbok tight five, Peter Durant, Tommy Loebscher, Mark Andrews, Philip Skutter, apart from Uli Schmidt, that's an average age of about 22 years old. Look at the ball Joost van der Westhuizen has gained. 37 of them going cleanly to Henny LaRue. Patterson cleans up beautifully. Chalmers couldn't hold on. South Africans offside. Now, Shield taking quickly, but running out, catching his forwards a little unaware. Driven on by McIver. Patterson, Chalmers. Gavin Hastings is up in the line. Nice grubber kick by Scott Hastings. Peter Hendricks does well. He got it away to Andre Yapere so deftly. Chalmers with a desperate defense. One hardly saw the deftness of Peter Hendricks' hands there.
Ongelukkige voorentoe aangee na Andre Joubert. Wat 'n opwindende speler is hier kerel.
That was good play there again by François Pinon, Doddy Weir. Referee indicating that the South Africans came in on the wrong side. Desperate running now by McIver. Held up by Henny LaRue. There's good play by David McIver. He's a reasonably small man for a loose forward. Shield, who's played nicely. Good tackling again by Peter Muller. Holding on to the ball in the tackle. But Peter Muller made a brilliant, a thundering tackle there.
Maar is ook baie interessant. Wanneer Chester Williams nou die verdediging doen, hou hom net op, Joe, dan probeer hy terselfdertyd die bal afneem, en dis waaroor dit gaan, en so byna dit reg gekry.
And another huge punt down into Scottish territory with that man Peter Muller. Certainly you, when he tackles you, you know you've been tackled.
Ja, Peter wat vandag in sy 16e toets speel, en ook 27 wedstrijde vir die Vrystaat gespeel en is weer Malk Andrews.
That's good play by Doddy Weir. He's tried hard at number 8 all afternoon. He's had to tackle so much. What Rakaiva, his body position is good. He gets really low. Patterson, Chalmers. Well, I bet all the guys around the country have all come off the golf course by now. 3 goals, 2 tries and a penalty. Can you believe it? 34 points to the solitary penalty by Gavin Hastings. It's been fabulous, fabulous rugby by the Green and Golds. High goes Rudolf Stowley. They've got that added arm now. Stowley and Pinard both being used as line-out forwards. Ribbon clear in support of Joost van der Westhuizen. Look at this man go. François Pinard's right on his shoulder, taking the opposition out. It's van der Westhuizen, now Henny LaRue. Look at the change of direction, so deft there. Joubert, now Rudolf Stowley. He'll power his way, this is Jaapie Mulder. Where's the support? Uli Schmidt comes in very quickly. Again, the dark blues in desperate defense. And now it's worked back to van der Westhuizen, Henny LaRue. Little bit of a mix-up between he and François Pinard. Good counter shove for Patterson to secure the ball. Oh, that was a bit of a shambles. The referee saying no, there was no advantage. Scottish put in at the scrum.
Gavin Hastings, wat nie 'n baie gelukkige toetswedstryd beleef nie.
You see Gavin Hastings looked for the open spaces and he was going to run that ball. Now, let's see what happens at this scrum.
Rudolf Stroyley, wat heeltemal weggebreek het, staan hier langs die scrum.
See Doddy Weir also packing at the side, giving Weir the protection. Now Chalmers, South Africa gaining ground from the scrum. It's just the continual pressure. Ruben Clear came off the side of that scrum so quickly. Patterson, he will remember this, his first test match, for a long time to come.
So van Ruben Clear gepraat, hy is natuurlijk baie sterk in sy boelijf en moeilik om neer te trek. Maar een reuse wedstrijd voor Zuid-Afrika.
Charlie went to the front. Well secured there by Reed. Patterson. Now Chalmers. And that was a good kick by Chalmers. Chester Williams thought about trying to grab it, but just was out of his reach. Well, Craig Chalmers will remember this day because he's had to tackle far more than he's been able to spin the ball down the back line.
Al bly so 13 minute oor in die tweede helfte. Suid-Afrika wat gerieflik voordoek met 34 punte teenoor 3. Die rusttydtelling was 8-0. Maar die eerste 20 minute in die tweede helft het Suid-Afrika hulle stempel op hierdie wedstryd heeltemal afgebreek.
Well, one again at the front of the line-out. Look at Henny LaRue just deciding where he wants to go. Oi, Shiel will know that he's running to Peter Muller, but it was a good tackle by the little blonde centre. The poor man has had to tackle so much today. Joost van der Veste isn't going to grab it out there. Ball on the ground, South Africa's advantage. You see how Peter Muller just thundered into Graham Shiel, and Graham Shiel and Scott Hastings have just had to do so much tackling all afternoon.
Daar kan ons sien hoeveel foute begaan is deur die Skotse spelers. Suid-Afrika wat die bal 14 keer by die vaste skerm gooi, Andre Joubert.
Oh, and again it was Logan who got his hand up in the air, just prevented Peter Hendricks from getting on the score sheet. Just inside the Scottish 22 meter area. See Patterson right in the thick of things there. Chalmers, that wasn't a bad pass there from Alan Sharp. Now Joubert again. Oh, now Andre Joubert decides, I'll just show these guys that I can also take a drop at goal. Wasn't that far away, I must tell you.
Andre Joubert, wat nou natuurlijk floreer in hierdie type spel. Goeie sewe spelers, Gavin Hastings.
Well, Chester Williams made the tackle on Gavin Hastings. He apologizes to the referee. Gavin Hastings, it just shows the quality of the dummy that he sold. Now, Hastings, this is desperate captain stuff. McIver, Peter Durant makes the tackle. Help again from Richardson and Reed. Patterson, Chalmers, Hastings. This is Stanger. Nicely on the inside to Scott. Hastings, beautifully tackled by Creer. Just inside the Scottish half, now Morrison, held up by Henny LaRue, then scragged by Tommy Lobsha. Good work by Richardson and Reed. That's the halfway line in picture.
Hier is Ruben Creer, wat beindruk van sy verdediging. Maar nadat hy die verdediging uitgevoer het, dadelijk weer op sy voete. En hierdie span is ongelooflik fiks. Om vir 80 minute in hierdie tempo te speel, nou ja, dit is 'n kenmerk van fiksheid.
10 minutes to go. Good scrum by the South Africans, McIver. He's a real forager for the ball, is David McIver. Patterson. Chester Williams is back for it. Uli Schmidt is in support. The referee, penalty to South Africa. Looks like Richard Reed, who's in a little bit of trouble. That man Patterson, who was the man who kicked it ahead. Now, Milne's gone wide. This will be a move by the forwards, and it gets out now to Scott Hastings. That was good dummy work amongst the forwards. Tony Stanger foraging for work right over from the right wing. Patterson again. Can't find anywhere to go. Peter Hendricks arrests the ball from him. Now Joost van der Vesthuizen, men on his outside. Yapi Mulder, see how he got his hands above the tackle. Beautiful play there by Rulo Charlie. Look at the support from the green and goals. Chester Williams gets on. Oh, this is fabulous football. Now Joost van der Vesthuizen trying to find him on the inside. It's Ruben Creer, but it didn't go. And listen to the crowd.
Vol punt aan Suid-Afrika vir hulle verdediging, maar kyk na die goeie ondersteunende spel. Andre Joubert wat vir Uli Schmid die bal gee. En dan 'n skerp beweging met Chester Williams, swak verdediging deur Skotland, Joost van der Westhuizen. En nou ook nou vir Ruben Creer dop wat gaan bykom. Kry die bal daarso en Suid-Afrika se losvoorspelers wat nou eerste by die afbreek.
This is Dodie Ware. He's well held up in the tackle by Francois Pina. Now Patterson. Ruben Creer desperate to clear across. Gavin Hastings can't find any blue jerseys to pass to. Quickly in there, Mark Andrews trying to get across the line of the ball. Now Patterson, Chalmers, Shiel, Scott Hastings. Look at that tackle by Chester Williams. I mean, that's a great defense. And he arrests the ball. Now Uli Schmidt, the little flip to Ruben Creer. Can Ruben Creer get it away? Yes, to Yapi Mulder. Now I know it's Henny LaRue. Henny LaRue, and Patterson knows that he's made a tackle now. Henny LaRue down, Dodie Ware tries to grab it. The referee says, hold on, you're miles offside, Dodie Ware.
Wel, as hierdie agterlyn van Skotland vanaand gaan slaap, gaan hulle droom van 'n groen golf wat aangerol kom na hulle, maar daai verdediging van Chester Williams was baie baie goed geweest en dan neem hy nog die bal ook af en wat 'n goeie toets beleef hierdie linkervleuel van Suid-Afrika nie.
Well, he's yet to have a bad test match and what great BMT he has. Van der Westhuizen, scorer of two tries. Henny Leroux gets it inside to his captain. What a proud day it is for his captain today for South Africa 16 times. André Joubert, oh, and he couldn't find Chester Williams. Uli Schmidt, always working hard. Look at the desperate defence by Patterson. Now Philip Skutter gets it away. This is Henny Leroux. Rubas Charlie thunders into three guys. Three guys it takes. Now look at all the green jerseys out there. Peter Muller must find somebody. Now Peter Hendricks, he gets under Logan's tackle and gets to his feet beautifully. Chester Williams is in quickly. Now a chance here for Henny Leroux to move it wide to Yapi Mulder. André Joubert come up into the line so often, he will get around that block forward. But the now Uli Schmidt keeps the ball and up and under from Uli Schmidt. Oh, Louis, I remember you doing that for Northern Transvaal way back in 1964.
Suid-Afrika wat hier 'n 3 kon aanteken. Ongelukkig Pieter Muller wat te lank in die bal vasgehou het. Jaapie Mulder na die Skotse heel agter stil staan. André Joubert wat nou feitelik in die agterlyn boer. Kyk na daardie vaartversnelling en dan Uli Schmidt wat 'n moeilike aangee kry.
Well, Craig Chalmers just getting some relief for Scotland, but you can see Craig Chalmers, he looks a little bit shell-shocked. I don't think he's ever played in an international where he's had to do so much tackling. Mark Andrews has worked hard. You can see the exhaustion on his face. Those will be three proud young men tonight. Peter Durant, Mark Andrews, Tommy Loebscher.
Oh,
a bit of a bad work there, but Morrison read it well. Peter Durant goes back to try and stop. You see Henny Leroux for the umpteenth time holding up. Now McIver for Scotland. Francois Pienaar gets across quickly and brings him to ground. Patterson, can Scotland achieve some pride? Charles, a great tackle by Uli Schmidt. And Hastings Morrison, who was up in the back line, now stands and watch Chester Williams almost arrested it. Now Ruben Krier does.
Strafskop. Ruben Krier wat gestraft gaan word.
Now Patterson moving it quickly to McIver. There Mark Andrews and Tommy Loebscher make the tackle. The blue jerseys drive in Philip Skutter. Referee says there were again there were two knock-ons. First one by South Africa. Look at McIver. He's prematurely grey, is that man. Says that his most embarrassing moments is when people call him Opa.
Een mens kan nie uitgepraat word of uitgepraat raak oor die goeie verdediging van Suid-Afrika nie.
Well, you see, the scrums awarded just those two, but in the midfield, South Africa have commanded everything. Chalmers moving it wide to Shiel. Scotland desperate now with Peter Muller very nearly got this. Is now Logan. Oh, Logan, every time he's touched the ball today, he's looked dangerous. Morrison rips it off him. Peter Durant makes a good tackle. Ball comes out to Scotland now. South Africa standing way offside. Shield gets it away to Hastings. Now Stanger gets in for the tie. And that's great work to the fight back by Scotland.
Tony Stanger. Sy 16e toetsdree. Maar 'n mens moet volpunte gee vir die skeidsregter ook. Terwyl die Skotse toeskouers hulle span groot applous gee. Die skeidsregter wat goeie voordeel hier toegepas het. Springbokke nou vir die eerste keer dat hulle op die aanval of althans op die verdediging gefaal het. Stanger, fop aangee, klop vir André Joubert. Henny Leroux is te hoog en Stanger 3.
Will it hook in? Oh, it's beautifully judged by the Scottish captain. And the crowd at last has something to shout about.
3 minute wat oorbly. Suid-Afrika wat hierdie toets maklik gaan wen. Maar het kon meer gewees het. Die Springbokke kon vandag 'n 50-tal behaal het. En dien hulle al hulle kansen geneem het in die eerste helfte.
Well, Well, one must also give credit to the blue jerseys of Scotland, have defended to a man. Very good green jerseys have just run at them all afternoon. Now, Seal. The crowd have really had a fantastic exhibition this afternoon of running rugby from both sides. What an occasion to open this magnificent stadium. Finally, Mr. Owen Doyle says, thank you very much, gentlemen. You've had your 82 minutes. And look at the spirit of the players as they say thank you for the game. It was a great, great exhibition. That man in the front of the picture, Francois Pienaar, will be a proud man today. 3 goals, 2 tries, 1 penalty to the penalty and goal of Scotland. 34 points to 10. And the crowd will go home knowing that they've seen a great game. And look at that man, Joost van der Westhuizen, with 2 superb tries.
Ek moet vir jou sê, Joost wat nie graag daardie trui sal wil afgee nie. Hy 2-3 gedruk. André Joubert reeds sy Skotse trui gekry. En wat 'n waardevolle trui, die trui van Gavin Hastings. 34-10, André Joubert. Hy het vanmiddag baie goed gespeel, deur en tyd in die agterlyn. Maar dit was 'n goeie vertoning deur die Springbokke. Hulle het gesukkel om net eerste 20 minute hulle ritme te vind. Maar die mense het die gevoel gekry dat dit net 'n kwessie van tyd sou wees voordat die Springbokke die oorhand sou kry. Pieter Hendricks wat deurkom, Hendricks wat sy toets op regterveld ook baie goed geslaag het. En ek moet met jou saamstem, Mio, dat hierdie 67,000 toeskouers op Murrayfield vandag 'n baie goeie vertoning van Francois Pienaar en sy 14 Springbok spanmaats gehad het.
Well, one just can't find too many words for these players. There you see the east stand that's directly opposite us of this, and it's that type of stand goes right the way around the ground. And the crowd around us here, we're out in the open, right next to Bill McLaren and next to Ray Gravel, the former Welsh centre who's here to commentate in Malay, Welsh language. There you see the guys from South Africa. They're very happy today. Everybody was a little bit worried about this test. Now watch this from Joost van der Westhuizen. As he gets away, ducks under the tackle so well, and then just keeps his feet, sells Gavin Hastings down the river, and that was try, bang, try number 2.
André Joubert in die agterlyn. Wat gaan hy doen? Top aangee. Netjies hardloop self in posisie aan Rudolf Stroyley. En dan Chester Williams. Niemand gaan vir Chester keer nie. En kyk sy regterhand hou reg om 'n man ook af te stamp. Maar daar was geen gevaar nie. En die glimlag is groot.
You saw Rudolf Stroyley come into that move and he's been so prominent in these moves. Yes, Patterson, watch McIver. He's there, he's a hard-working flank forward, just getting in the way of his man.
Shield wat die bal gee vir Gavin Hastings. Steinger.
In fact, that was a little unlucky for South Africa, because Gavin Hastings, I thought it was deft handwork by him, but it was actually Rudolf Stroyley who just came in, brought an arm in to make the tackle that knocked the ball into Stanger's hands. So a little bit of luck, in fact, for Scotland there, because Gavin Hastings had very definitely dropped that ball.
Groot klomp teleeggestelde Skotse toeskouers wat huis toe gaan. En hoe anders was het nie vandag nie, in 1969, toe Suid-Afrika hy verloor het, en daar 25,000 mense was.
Yes, François, you must feel very proud of the way
you
played
out
by Pienaar. It's a proud
day
for that man.
You know, it's been a long tour, it's been a tough year for us, but the guys really played well today. I'm very happy with the way we played, and when we got the opportunities, we scored the tries. We sneaked in the beginning with magic from our scrum off. He really put us on the map, and from there on, the forwards ran onto the ball, and, you know, we were able to score.
In the second half, where did you feel that it went right for you and went badly wrong for Scotland?
Well, we went 15 points up, and that's a good cushion. When you're 15 points up, obviously you must run the ball, and that was my recommendation to the backs, to run the ball. At the end, we ran a bit of at angles and not straight forward, and we could have penetrated, I feel, a bit more. But, you know, it's a great victory and a great comeback from this year's performances.
Did you feel that the players produced a lot extra today because this was a test match?
Yes, you know, you want to peak in the test matches, and obviously you want to play your best game in the test matches, and I felt that the guys came out with a mission.
And next mission is Wales. How do you fancy
that? Well, next mission is we're playing Pontypridd, I think, on Tuesday, and we'll first look towards that game before we look towards the test.
Well done today. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.
Well, a proud day for Francois Pienaar today. His 14th test match and 14, all 14, as captain of South Africa. And this is by far his best win of all time. 34 points to 10 as we return you back in a very happy mood to Randburg.
Thanks, Hugh, and thanks, John, there. In a magic mood, a wonderful, wonderful win, Nas. It was a fantastic performance all round. Can you pick out any body or any group, the tight five or whatever, as the people who really made it happen?
Yeah, Gary, I think what happened is in the second half, the tight five really got going. They controlled the ball excellent, and, you know, we just got into sort of the rhythm we've been looking for 3 years now, and suddenly it just looked easy.
And you're actually saying before the game that if the scrum half and fly half, Joost and Henny, got it together, that would be the foundation for a win. Did they do the job for you today?
Yeah, it's, you know, that I think that was the major thing. Joost actually switched the game, scoring just before halftime. And then straight after halftime, he scored another try. And I think Henny also, you know, when we were under pressure, he kicked well today. And Joost also kicked well. He didn't kick it out. Kicked the up and unders. We kept Scotland under pressure, and it was just a matter of time before we were going to score the tries. And I think that the three tries we scored in about a space of 10 minutes, you know, just killed them off.
Now, as you said earlier, that Chester Williams is your man of the season. He certainly proved that today, hey?
Yeah, him and Andre is playing very well at the moment. I'm not talking about today, the whole team played well. But the way Chester played the whole season, even for Western Province, when they were sort of not having good games, you know, he was still playing well. And you know, if you look at his class today, I'm telling you, you can put him there where David Campisi is.
And what about the new cap, Philip Scooter? He played well today as well.
Yeah, I played with Philip at Northern Transvaal, and you know, I've always liked him, and then he sort of picked up hassles at Northern, and that's why he left, you know. But he's always been there, and I think maybe today was the day to give him the opportunity to go out and prove himself, and he did that.
Now, I was just looking at the managers. Many people felt that Ian Mack had done fairly well with the Springbok squad, was maybe a little bit unlucky not to achieve the success. But looking at the performance today, do you think Kitch's new involvement, you think that's really turned the team around?
Yeah, Gary, but I think what we must do is let's look at where we started. I think John Williams also contributed something, and then Mack also. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think Kitch, the main thing, you know, what we've got at the moment is we sorted out the tight head. It looks like Tommy Lobsher is definitely the tight head that we've been looking for the last 3 years. And suddenly we've got a number four lock. You just can't go on one performance, but we've got to go on today's performance, and the guys did well. And I think the other success we had, and I think that's one thing that you've got to give Kitch credit for, is the loose forward combination that we've got right at last. You know, I feel sorry for a guy like Tian, but the way Tian, Francois and Rudolph played today, there's just no place for anybody else. And we've been looking for combinations the last 3 years, and it looks like we've got it at the moment.
Yeah. Looking at Ruben Kruger, Peter Miller, some great tackling there, magic performance by both of them.
Yeah, if you take Peter Miller, you know, he had sort of bad games or didn't play that well this season, but suddenly he's coming to form, and that's what we need. We need stars in a team. If you go into a test side, you need at least 10 stars. And if you look at today, you know, today we had 15. We just hope that next week we can at least have 10, because if you've got 10, 11, then you can win any test. And the way the guys play today, it's, you know, at least I don't want to say we're going to be in the World Cup final, but at least it looks good.
Now, looking ahead to next weekend's test against Wales, do you foresee any changes to the South African side? Or, having said all that, do you think there's going to be any changes, or do you think it's going to be the same side as today?
I think luckily, you know, the guys walked off the field today, so it looks like there's no major injuries. I just believe, you know, and that's been proven, that you never change the winning combination. So this should be the combination for next week. And you know, this should be at least the nucleus for the World Cup, for sure.
And Nas, just to finish, watching that performance there, does Nas Botha wish he could still be playing?
Yeah, it's...
Well, I heard the comments behind me, and that certainly was going through.
No, but it's nice. I think we've waited 3 years for this performance. We had good performances, you know, the first test against France in 92, even the test we played against the All Blacks here, the first test against Australia, but you know, we've been waiting for this game, and at least we've got it at last. And That's why I said before the tour, you know, if we can just get the team going for the World Cup, then, you know, we've succeeded in this tour and we've done that.
Well, there you go. Thanks, Nas Berto. Very happy, Nas Berto, and I'm sure everybody out there watching happy today. Delighted with a fantastic performance. Well done to Francois and the lads, and I hope they have a good night celebrating tonight. Of course, a big match next week, that Wales match, and we'll give you details of that in a moment or two. Coming up...